This is Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, and he's immortal. And yeah, that makes sense, because despite the fact he died a long time ago, he lives on in his music, and he is considered one of the greatest composers to have ever lived. But he's not just that kind of immortal. A piece of Mozart's work is featured on the golden records attached to the Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft. They were launched 16 days apart in the summer of 1977, and their primary mission was to study the outer planets of our solar system. After their first goal was complete, the Voyagers set course to interstellar space. They have been operational for over 44 years as of the making of this video, and the Voyager 1 is currently the most distant artificial object from Earth. As of January 21st, 2022, it's about 23 billion kilometers away from our planet. And in 2012, it officially left the solar system behind forever, the first human-made object to do so. The golden records are a kind of snapshot of humanity, a time capsule meant for whoever happens to find them in the depths of space. They have all sorts of music from all over the world, from a Peruvian wedding song to Chuck Berry's Johnny Be Good, but also sounds from Earth, like the wind, crickets, birds, thunder, human footsteps, and laughter. There's also 116 images showcasing our solar system, our planet, and our species. There's pictures of the sun, of DNA, of people, landscapes, and cities, and an astronaut in space. And last but not least, there's greetings from the people of planet Earth in 55 languages. The cover of the records has diagrams engraved in it that explain how to use it, and a kind of map of nearby pulsar's relative position to our sun, so the recipients of the record can figure out where it came from. The Voyagers and the golden records are designed to last millions, maybe even billions of years in the cold depths of the universe. All the people that appear on the golden record, whether in an image, a song they sang or wrote, or a friendly hello they said, will outlive all of us, and they might outlive humanity itself. It took a year to select music, sound, and images for the records. And the simple fact people put so much effort into making them at all and making sure they can be universally understood shows that we really want them to be found. We know that they may fly through empty space for an extremely long time, but the idea is that we put ourselves out there, an intelligent, self-aware species from a small blue world, for the whole galaxy to see. We truly hope that somebody else is out there and that we're not alone in the darkness. And maybe somebody will find our message and see us and think, hey, there's other people. And they're a lot like us. But what if we're wrong? What if the Voyagers are lost in space and time forever? What if our carefully crafted message will aimlessly float in the cold, uncaring void until it's completely eroded away? It is an uncomfortable thought, but it's not unlikely. The probability of intelligent alien life is a topic of debate in the scientific community. And both sides on the argument have good points. In the 1970s and 80s, scientists like Carl Sagan and Frank Drake spearheaded the now popular idea that life may be common in the universe, based on the principle of mediocrity. Our galaxy is but one of millions. Our sun is just a common star, and many stars have planets, so logically, life could be very common as well. After all, just look at the amount of stars in our galaxy alone. At least 200,000 million stars, and many are similar to our sun. The discovery of the first exoplanet in 1992 definitely proved that at the very least our sun is not unique for having planets orbiting around it. And scientists estimate there could be at least 100 billion exoplanets in our Milky Way alone. So far, there's 5,000 confirmed exoplanets, and many orbit their star in the habitable zone, the zone where liquid water can persist on a planet's surface. And where there's liquid water, there could be life. The sheer amount of possible planets just waiting to be discovered makes it seem like other life forms could potentially be found everywhere in the galaxy. There's more. Studies of life on Earth, what it's made of, and how it may have begun show life can survive in extreme circumstances, like in very cold or very hot environments. So it seems life might not even need Earth-like conditions to thrive. Molecules needed for the building blocks of life, such as carbon and oxygen, are abundant in the universe, and they may have started to form as soon as 100 million years after the Big Bang. Complex organic molecules have been found in meteorites on Earth that are 4 billion years old. And fossils show that life on Earth began pretty much as soon as that was possible. And then there's the fact we have found traces of water all over the solar system. There used to be water on Mars, there's water ice on the Moon and Mercury, and in comets, and there's water vapor in the atmosphere of Jupiter's biggest moon, Ganymede. Titan, Saturn's biggest moon, has surface liquid in the form of liquid methane, and it forms rivers, lakes, and seas. It's not water, but it's liquid, so life would have to get a little bit creative, but hey, why not methane-based life? That all sounds terrific. Lots of stars, lots of planets, lots of stuff that life as we know it is made of. Pretty much everywhere, so lots of aliens, right? Let's slow down a little bit and look at the counterarguments. In the year 2000, Peter Ward and Donald Brownlee published their book Rare Earth: Why Complex Life is Uncommon in the Universe. In this book, they argue that life as it exists on Earth is incredibly rare and needs very specific circumstances in order to begin and survive long enough to evolve the complexity as it exists today. It would require our specific place in the galaxy, a star just like our sun, and a very similar orbit of a smaller rocky planet. Also a large planet like Jupiter, to keep pesky apocalypse-inducing meteors out of the way, and then a large moon to stabilize the rotation of the planet, an atmosphere with the right chemical composition, plate tectonics, and one or more triggers for complex life. After all, it took 3.5 billion years for life on Earth to evolve from simple single-celled organisms into multicellular beings. Ward and Brownlee argue that microscopic life might turn out to be rather common in the universe, but the series of events that ended with an intelligent species like us are so unlikely, it's perfectly possible it may have happened just once. One reason we've convinced ourselves that we're not alone is survivor's bias. We are here, so others must be as well, right? Well, maybe. The truth of the matter is, we just don't know. So far, the only absolute proof of life in the universe is the life on our planet, and that's it. We also have not been looking for alien life for that long. We've only been doing it for a few decades, because we simply didn't have the technology to do so for most of human history. Of the possible billions of exoplanets, we've only found a tiny fraction of them. Maybe there's not other life out there right now, but there could be in a distant future, and the Voyagers will last a very long time. So even if life is rare, they might still be found and studied, even if that takes a million years or more. Well, there's the other problem. It's not just the probability of alien life that could be an issue, but also the probability that the Voyagers can be found at all. Let's take a look at where they're going. Neither probe is headed towards any particular star, but by calculating their trajectories, scientists know that Voyager 1 will pass within 1.7 light years of the red dwarf star Gliese 445. In about 40,000 years. Voyager 2 will pass by the small star Ross 248 in about 42,000 years. If left undisturbed, it will continue on and pass the star Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky, in 296,000 years. That's an unimaginably long time. If you go back 300,000 years into the past, human beings didn't even exist. Our ancestors were still wandering the plains of Africa. And yet, it's just a blink of an eye in the cosmic timescale. Another thing to consider is that the Voyagers are tiny compared to most other stuff that traverses the universe. They're roughly the size of a car, and by the point they pass any star, they will have been dead and cold for thousands of years. So it would be like trying to find a needle in the biggest haystack you can imagine. And there's no telling if anyone is even looking for spacecraft from other worlds. With the technology we currently have on Earth, we would never be able to find an alien probe the size of Voyager if it passes by us at about a light year distance. And if we did find it by some incredible coincidence and recognize what it was, we would not be able to retrieve it. So the odds of other civilizations finding Voyager seem extremely small. They travel too slow and they do not stand out in the vastness of space. Then what about the distant future? What is the ultimate fate of Voyager? Could they truly last for billions of years? If enough time passes, they may be found after all, even if it's just a tiny chance, right? How long will the golden records be playable for? Scientists think at least a billion years, provided the spacecraft don't crash into anything. But the odds for that are fairly low, since interstellar space is mostly empty. It's estimated that the average density of the universe is about 6 protons per cubic meter. Now that's an average, so interstellar space outside of star systems and clouds of cosmic dust is going to be even emptier. The only damage that the spacecraft will sustain is dust particles smashing into them and leaving microscopically small craters, so they will erode ever so slowly. and that might take billions of years, depending on where exactly they travel, but that's impossible to predict. In 500 million years, the solar system and the Voyagers will have completed one full orbit of the Milky Way galaxy. By that point, the face of the Earth and positions of the stars in the night sky will be completely unrecognizable, and there's no telling what happened to humanity. The Voyagers are now ancient relics of a civilization that is long gone, even if their descendants could still be alive. The probes are forever witnessing the dance of the stars, the hope of ever being found and touched again slowly decaying, along with the spacecraft themselves. In 5 billion years, the Milky Way galaxy and its neighbor, the Andromeda galaxy, will collide. It's highly unlikely that stars will actually smash into each other. There's just too much space in between them. But the two galaxies will merge into a bigger, irregular one. This far into the future, the Voyagers may have passed through a star system, and the most incredible thing is it might be one that doesn't exist yet. Many of the stars we know of today will be gone. They're leftover clouds of dust, now a part of bright new stars, and who knows, completely new intelligent civilizations. But by that time, the sun will be gone. It will reach the end stage of its life in about 4 billion years, swell up into a red giant, and swallow the inner planets Mercury and Venus. Earth will likely be engulfed by the sun as well. Then, our star, that once provided life on a small blue world with warmth and energy, will go nova and blast its outer layers into space, leaving only its core behind. If the Earth survives the onslaught of a dying star, what will remain of it is just a cold, dead rock orbiting a white dwarf for billions of years to come. Maybe the Voyagers and their golden records will still be out there, somewhere, in a future so distant they will be coursing through a truly alien universe. Reduced to skeletons barely holding together, the spacecraft would be drifting in a cosmos that seems empty. The universe is expanding at an accelerating rate, and so all matter is moving away from each other. At some point, other galaxies will no longer be visible from our own. They will be too far away. Our spacecraft simply can't last forever, and so at some point they will fall apart, and the records will be lost. But it was still a valiant effort of humanity to make ourselves a little immortal. Our machines could someday be the last remaining artifacts of a species of thinking, stargazing dreamers, who imagined that there were others just like ourselves, somewhere in the darkness. So then, are the golden records pointless? Did we make them for nothing? Is it naive, even a little arrogant, to think they will ever be found and their message deciphered? Given the enormous scale of both space and time, it would seem so. And it's okay to be aware of this, and give it some thought, and realize that there are so many things we simply don't know. There is no definitive answer to the question this video poses. The people that worked on the Voyagers and the records didn't know either, but we can hope it's worth a shot, even if it's quite literally a shot in the dark. A lot has changed in the 44 years since the probes were launched. The world feels smaller. And it looks like we cannot overcome our worst traits, our greed and selfishness, and our hatred for the light in each other's eyes. Maybe there is truth to the idea that intelligent civilizations tend to self-destruct, and that's the reason we haven't found any, or have been found by one that did rise above itself and now wanders the stars. But in many ways, the records represent the best of humanity, our perseverance and ingenuity, our diversity and creativity, or desire to connect with others and share what we love, think, and dream. The records have the inscription, "To the makers of music, all worlds, all times," hand-etched on their surface. It's by all means incredible. We can even imagine beings that we will never meet, who could be completely different from us, could one day be listening to us. From Mozart to Chuck Berry, to the sound of the ocean, to what we sound like when we're happy. It's a way for humanity to capture immortality. Even if we are wiped out by some unforeseen catastrophe, even if we perish by our own doing, a splinter of all the best things that we were is on these records, and they will exist for long after their creators have died. And maybe, just maybe, the universe is not as dark and unforgiving as it seems. and someone somewhere will experience this thin sliver of humanity and wonder where we are now and if we're still making music. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon.